So hello guys, in this video I'm going to show you how we can create WhatsApp OTP verification app using MIT App Inventor. So here we go. So what we need to do here, we need to click on start new project and we are going to create this app using MIT App Inventor. So that app name is WhatsApp OTP verification, okay? You can implement this functionality in your all app whenever you need authentication. Okay, so this is our first screen here. Now I'm going to drag and drop here layouts, click on layout and just drag and drop one vertical arrangement. Make this fill parent like this. And let me just make this background color to the black and click on user interface and just drag and drop one button and one text box. Simple. Now click on vertical arrangement and make this thing in a center like this. Click on this text box and click on width. Make it at least 70%. Click on this button and enter send OTP like this. You can change the background color of this button to orange or anything. Font bold. Click on the text box and change this text to enter your number with country code like this. Enter number with country code like this. Now I'm going to use our one label to make some space like this. Done. Now let's copy this vertical arrangement and just copy paste it here. So I have two arrangements. So I'll just hide first one, just visible off. Visual turn on is this one. And instead of this button, I'll just say verify OTP. Verify OTP like this. And here I'll just put the enter OTP like this. Done. Now what I will do, I'm going to use here one more this label, okay, and I'll remove the text from this label. I will make this text color to be red. So if someone put the wrong OTP, then we'll display the wrong OTP text here. That's it. Now I need one screen here. So in the above, you can see add screen. Just click on this screen two. Just okay. So as you can see, that's my second screen. So I'm going to use your one label and I'll just change this text to something. This is my another like this. Okay. It's fine. Let's make it in a center like this. Done. So that's my another screen. So let's open the first screen. Now let's do the code. Okay. Now go to the block. So what we need to do, whenever click on vertical arrangement first. Okay. And click on button one. And whenever someone click on this, so I need to hide vertical arrangement one. Okay. This should be visible. False. Okay. And the another arrangement should be visible true. It means two. Now on the button click, we have to send OTP. So how can I do this? So to send the OTP, we need a API. Okay. So how can I get that API? So this one platform, and that platform name is called bulkchatbot.co.in. Using this platform, you can have the free account. You can have 100 WhatsApp SMS totally free of cost. So you need to sign up into this, okay? And then you need to just log in, okay? So I already have account, so let's click on the login. So after the login, as you can see here, we have the 100 SMS, right? So in the left side, you will find the WhatsApp. Click on this, okay? I will give you that website link in the description. This is the apps.bulkchatbot.co.in. Now, as you can see, the add account, click on this and wait some seconds. And you will receive the scanner code like this. Okay. What do you need to do? You need to open your WhatsApp. Okay. After opening WhatsApp, you need to just scan that code. Okay. So this WhatsApp, my WhatsApp or whatever your WhatsApp, will connect with this platform. Okay. After connecting this, you need to go to the WhatsApp. So I already have connected with one of my accounts. Let me just show that account. After adding the account, we need to go to the profile. Okay. And as you can see, the select WhatsApp accounts, we need to just click on this and we need to select. As you can see, I already have added this. So Sorodo is here. So I need to just select this one. Now, as you can see here, you will find the instant ID and the access token. Okay. So you need to just use that instant ID and access token. Okay. So what we need to do here, let's go to the API left side in the bottom. See this one. Now we need to use here one API and that is called post send text, this one API. Okay. So what I will do, I will give you the API. Okay. So the API is at the end, you will find that API like this. So as you can see, the user number we need to put, if you want to send message to your friends, you need to put your friend's number here. Then you need to enter the message. As you can see, message equal your message, then instant ID and the your access token. Okay, and where you will get all this thing, number you have, the message you have, you just need instant ID and token ID. We already have learned how we can get that ID. Done. Now what we need to do, we need to just do one thing here. Let's divide this thing. Okay, so how we can divide this? So it's very basics, because we need to get the number from the user. So what I will do, I'll just copy the whole till this equal, okay, like this one. Till equal, I will copy that text and go to the MIT App Inventor here. Okay. Now we need to go to the text here, okay, and let's copy here this one and just paste it here. Done. Now I need one more text value, and where I can have my number, user's number. So what I will do, let's go to the design, and you'll find just visual of this, make it visual on. As you can see here, we will get the number from here, the text box 1.txt. So let's use the join like this, and text box 1.txt, I'll use this here like this. Now this is our half API, right? After we will get the number. Now what I need here, I just need one more thing here. So suppose let's just a string and one more string like this. Okay, now let's copy this here. Okay, so we have to complete that API, right? So we have done with number. Now let's open that type and equal to text, and it's message and equal. We need to copy till this. Okay, so just copy it here like this. Now we need a number. Okay, so we need to find the random message, because it's a OTP. So click on match and you will see the random integer, this one. Okay, and I'll just do one thing here. Okay, so what I will do here, I will just create one variable here. Okay, so how can I do this? So it's really quite simple. Let's click on the variables, just initialize one variable, and that is our OTP, right? So I'll assign this OTP to nothing right now like this. Okay, but and the OTP, just set that here like this, and we need to just set this as a random integer. So how can I do this? So it's really very simple. So we're going to use here again one join like this, and I'm going to set this OTP here. So if you need a OTP like 4-number OTP or 3-number OTP, so you need to just add more strings like this here. Okay, and let's copy paste this, then this, and again like this. Okay, and make sure this should be 9, 9, 9, and 9. Now as you can see here, we have the OTP. okay, now we need this OTP. okay, so how can I get that? So I'll just get that OTP from here itself like this. Okay, now we need to complete this API. Now what we have done, we have done till OTP, it means text message, your message. Okay, now we need to add the instant ID and access token. So I'll just copy that. I already have one instant ID and token. Okay, so what I will do, I'll use my own API. So I'll just use here one more string, and in that string go to the text, and I'll use here this, and I will just paste it here. It means what we have done in the API, we have done, we are getting two things as an input. It means one is number from user, and second thing is OTP from our own system, like we are generating the OTP here, right? Now we have to call this API. So how we can call this API? It's really very easy, because it's just a REST API, so we just need to hit this. Okay, so how can I do this? Go to the design, click on variable, just drag and drop this variable, make sure this should be visible off like this. Okay, now let's go to the block here and click on web view, and you will find the is go to URL component, like go to the URL, this one, just call it here and join this. It's done. So what we have done till now, we have hide the arrangement one, visual on this, generate the OTP, and we are sending this OTP to that particular number. Now what we need to do, we need to verify this, right? It's working fine or not. So click on worker arrangement 2 and click on button 2. So once the people click on the button 2, so we need to check this OTP is correct or not. Okay, how can I do this? So it's really simple. I'm going to use your control if, okay, and then I just need logic equal, and I just need the get OTP. If the get OTP, if the get OTP is equal to the text box 2, because we have to put my OTP in the text box 2. is equal, then I'll open another screen. So just type here open another screen, like this. Open another screen, this one, call it here, and just copy this, paste it here, like this. And another screen name is screen 2, like this. Else if the OTP is wrong, then I'll just say here label 3 dot text, okay, this one, and is equal to the wrong OTP. That's it. Okay, so that's the whole program that we have done. So as you can see here, enter number with country code. So let me just put my number with my country code 91. Now we need to click on send OTP. As you can see, enter OTP. Now I have to open my WhatsApp to check my OTP. So let me just try the wrong OTP number here. So suppose this, and let's try to click on verify OTP. As you can see, the wrong OTP. Okay, let me just try to put the correct OTP here. Okay, so the correct OTP is 2352. And let's click on verify OTP. As you can see, this is your second screen. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you have any doubt, you can ask me on comment. Please subscribe my channel, like this video and share this video. Have a nice day. Be safe. Bye bye.